Mike Tyson. Mike is waiting for your challenge. Hello everyone, Treecks here and welcome to my newest weekend project. Welcome to Mike Tyson's Punch-Out. Starring Little Mac and his trainer, Doc Lewis. Also playing the role of Mac, it's you, the player. With that, they mean me. This is a story of true victory, but the road is long. And Mike Tyson will be waiting on the end. Welcome to Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, the NES remake of the classical arcade title Punch-Out, which is basically a boxing game, one of Nintendo's first fighting games they ever made. And this game was originally an arcade title, and later got ported to the NES with the help of Mike Tyson, one of the most famous boxing champions of all time. His name was licensed for this game. He was added as an extra final boss to this game. And basically, besides that, is still the story of Punch-Out, where we play as Little Mac, underdog, newcomer fighter from the Bronx in New York, who is twice as small, sometimes even smaller, than all of the opponents he's going to meet. And he's still going to overcome all of the odds against him and try to become the boxing champion. A pretty fun game, in all honesty. It's also really tough, so some experience is definitely required for me to think I can beat this game. But this game actually makes use of a lot of reaction time-based fighting and finding out weaknesses in your opponents and trying to exploit that while trying to avoid everything they are going to throw at you. Trying to wear out your opponent before they wear you out and try to knock them out. And even if you don't, do well enough in order to be able to win on points. One of the most challenging games ever made to beat. I think I can beat the original Punch-Out pretty easily. That I've done quite a number of times in the past. However, like I said, this game is a little bit different than the original arcade game, since it added Mike Tyson as an ultimate final boss in this game. And that is actually where the real challenge in this game comes, because that is actually one of the hardest things I have ever done in video games. I think I've only beaten him once on accident in my life, so I'm not even too sure if I'm able to do it in this Let's Play, but I'll at least try to focus on the original Punch-Out part of this game, fighting all of these awesome opponents, well-designed characters that we're going to meet, and trying to climb the ladder and become the world champion boxing, as small as we are, as Little Mac. Okay, this game makes use of a password system. Most of the NES games do. But as you can see, we have a passkey system here, which you can input a passcode the moment you have beaten or lost at a certain point while going through the circuit. But we're just starting, so I'm not going to use that now. I'm going to go new game. Let's go. Become the world champion. Let's keep it clean. Now come out boxing. Our first opponent in the minor circuit. Of course, we start in the minor circuit, since we're newbies. And our first opponent is going to be Glass Joe. As you can see, he sucks. He has only had one KO in his career and 99 times he has been beaten himself. A French guy from Paris. All of the statistics you can see here. And since we're new, we have no victories and no KOs yet, so... But this guy is actually here to be the tutorial for this game. This guy is here to teach you how it works. He's going to be our human punching bag, because this guy is ridiculously easy. He should be, since he's our first opponent and is going to have to teach us how this game works. Okay, after the introduction cutscene for our opponent, it's time for Glass Joe to step into the ring and for me to start explaining how this game works. Okay, first of all, controls. We can press A or B in order to punch, as you can see. Pretty basic, he'll block everything we'll throw at him. We can also throw punches a little bit upward by holding up, so we can punch higher. We can press down to block a move, or we can press left or right in order to dodge a move. As you can see, he's going to try to punch us now. If we press left or right, we can dodge his attacks. And if we get hit, we lose some health, as you can see. And if we hit him, he loses health. Do make sure you hit him in the right spot, because as you can see, if he has his defense lowered, we can only hit him in the face. And if he's blocking his face, we can only punch him in the stomach. So definitely make sure you know where you're punching, either low or high. And be careful not to run out of stamina, because every move you miss, you actually lose a heart. You can see that at the top left of the screen, the hearts. That is basically your stamina. And the moment you run out, you can not do anything for a couple of moments. And the moment the game thinks you exploit the weakness of the opponent well enough, you actually receive some stars. I'll show that off in a minute, because usually the first time you down an opponent, it's not going to be a KO immediately. Usually they get up. But if you press start, the moment we have some stars, we can actually do a super punch. Oh, time ran out in the middle of a super punch. But in between rounds, you actually get these dialogues from the characters. Doc Lewis, our trainer, will say a couple of things. And even our opponent will say a couple of things. Which are usually pretty funny, like in his case. Watch the jaw. Don't hit my jaw. This guy's a complete wimp. It's not for nothing that he's the lowest ranked fighter in this game. The lowest in the minor circuit, and therefore the easiest to beat. I'm curious who the only KO this guy ever had in his career, who that actually was. There we go. Super punch in the face, which of course does a lot more damage than a normal punch does. So try to use that whenever the health of the opponent is low, so you can down him. And usually it takes around 3, 4, and in later opponents sometimes even more. Times to floor the opponent before they actually give up and you get a KO. Okay, punch him in the stomach a couple of times as long as he's not blocking that. Okay, third time he's out of health and falls down to the ring again. And yeah, it's pretty hilarious how Mario's actually the referee in this game. Bam! You are down. Four times down. Yeah, he gives up. TKO, and we win our first match. And trust me, if you have trouble with this guy, then you'd better stop playing. But anyway, we won by technical knockout. We move up in the rankings, rank 2, and we're ready for the next challenge. And that is basically how this game works. The more opponents we beat, the higher we rank, and the more tough the opponents get. As you can see, this is actually someone who knows what he's doing. 23 times he has won in his career, and only 13 times lost. Von Kaiser, from Berlin, Germany. Okay, with the easy opponents done, it's time to really get started with this game. Most of the opponents in this game are going to be based on some kind of weakness they have that we need to exploit. Most of the time it's going to be some kind of tell that they have. Like this guy, as you can see, waves his head a little bit and his mustache, which you can see as a tell when he's going to attack. And the moment you see him do that, you know, oh, a punch is coming in, and then quickly move out of the sight. And then you can actually hit him the moment he misses. That's one of the things you're going to want to exploit with most of the opponents in this game. The moment they miss an attack, they try to punch you and you step out of the way. Most of the opponents in this game are going to be vulnerable after that. So the moment they miss one of their punches, immediately punch yourself. Because usually they don't have any defense the moment they miss you. And you can usually get a few punches in. Especially if they miss these big moves like this crouch move that Von Kaiser uses. And the moment he does that, if he misses, he usually leaves himself open wide. And you can get a few punches in. But do time it correctly, because as you can see, the moment he starts crouching down, he does not immediately make a move. And that can be one of the trickiest things in this game, learning the timing of your opponents. How fast they attack, how long certain attacks last, or whenever an attack gets initiated, how long it will take before the actual punch comes. Learning stuff like that in all of your opponents, that's the biggest challenge here. So you don't dodge too early or dodge too late. But this first episode is going to be mostly introduction, because the minor circuit is of course the easy part of this game. The champion of the minor circuit is Piston Honda, a Japanese fighter who actually lost only once in his career. And therefore, you might say, knows what he's doing. But we have not lost a single time in our career. We've only had 2 matches and both won. But okay. Our Japanese friend over here is actually 3 times our size, it seems. But we're not scared of him. We know how to dodge his moves. His tail is actually his eyebrows, as you can see, for his normal move. His charge move is pretty easy to tell as well, because he usually charges it first, as you can see here. He holds his arm back before he actually punches you. Pretty easy to see coming. No guarantee that you will automatically avoid it, of course. Ooh, here's a super move. The super move is pretty scary, actually. What you're going to want to do is, whenever he charges at you, hit him yourself, because he does not defend his super move. But if he hits you, you are down instantly, so be careful for that. It is pretty risky to try to attack him while he's doing it. Okay, big combo, there we go. If you have stars, always try to finish a combo off with a super punch of yourself. Because usually you can throw your opponents down in one hit if you do that. Because it's pretty obvious that whenever an opponent is stun-locked because of your combo, he's not able to defend. So it's an easy super punch to get in. Because when your opponent is able to defend, it's pretty hard to get the super punch in. Usually they block it or avoid it. It's tricks like this you're going to have to want to learn quickly if you want to progress pretty far in this game. But anyway, these easy opponents done. We have a new champion in the minor circuits. Little Mac only needed 3 matches in order to become the champion in the lowest circuit. Don't start celebrating too soon, because like I explained, this was only the easy part of this game. There is of course more than just the minor circuit. And for that, Doc Lewis is going to take us through the streets of New York. We need some training in our beautiful pink training suit. I love how this training suit is also one of the costumes you can choose from in Super Smash Bros. Because Little Mac is also in Super Smash Bros. Of course now. And this training suit you find in these training sessions in between circuits is actually one of the circuits there, of course. Or one of the costumes there. But the moment you have cleared one of the circuits, you will get the password. So remember that in case you fail in the next one. And that can happen, because now we are at the major circuit. And our first opponent there is going to be Don Flamenco from Spain. And this guy is of course a lot better than what we faced in the minor circuit. Still shouldn't be a problem. I'm pretty experienced with this game, I feel, so these guys usually don't give me trouble yet. But they might, they might. I'm a little bit distracted because of the Let's Play, but you might never know. This guy is doing its best to show off how Spanish he is. But he's also a boxer. So, time to take this guy out. Let's go see if we can see what his stealth is. Oh, you're this guy. He's the taunting guy, yeah. Don Flamenco always taunts his opponents a lot. He thinks he's a big shot. And his deal is actually countering a lot, as you can see. He's going to wait for us to make the first move, dodge that, and then make a move of his own. Everything we've been doing ourselves the last couple of opponents, he's going to do himself this time. Only downside to it is, he leaves himself open if he misses it. So it's pretty easy to take down with this combo, as you can see. Making this guy still pretty easy. He's going to use our weapons, everything we've been using in the minor circuit so far. And he will... would be nice if he actually dodged his moves. But yeah, the stamina does not only get drained down if you miss moves yourself. Getting hit will also drain down your stamina, so that can also make you run out of hearts. This guy is usually pretty easy to get a combo on, as you can see. If you just keep on pressing your punch buttons, you can get the combo going indefinitely on this guy. It's just a matter of avoiding his combos, or his counters. The moment he has been KO'd, or he has been knocked down the first time, usually he'll start attacking on his own, but he will still counter, of course. It's just a matter of not missing your attacks, which is pretty easy, because the combo you can keep going indefinitely, as long as you don't miss your combos. Just keep on pressing your punch button. Don't give him a chance to get his recomposure, and he should be really easy. This is kind of fighter that only becomes hard if you give him the chance to do so. But okay, that said, I think King Hippo, the next guy we're going to face, is from some island in the South Pacific. He's pretty unknown. We don't know how old he is or how much he weighs. But trust me, it's a lot. And this is the first guy I consider where this game actually starts becoming somewhat challenging. This is for the first time where you actually start noticing that some tricks are actually necessary in order to defeat your opponents. So far, it has been nothing but countering your opponents and just making use of the combos. But this guy actually requires a little bit more than that. Because this guy is actually more than just wait for him to miss his moves and then punch yourself. Like I said, this guy's a little bit harder. And if you get knocked down yourself, you need to button mash the A button to get up. And the more you get knocked down, the harder it becomes. So be careful for that. But if you lose your health, you're knocked down completely yet. You still have a chance to get up again. Just like your opponents, of course. But okay, the way this guy works is actually like this. You're going to want to lure him into trying to punch you. And the moment he starts blocking his face, you're going to want to try to hit that. And the moment he does that, he actually will lower his trousers for some reason. And the moment his trousers fall down, he's actually distracted, you might say, try to pull it back up, so he won't be able to defend himself. And that is what you're going to want to use to punch him. So punch him in the gut the moment he tries to raise his pants up again, and then you're going to want to hit him. And get used to this, because this is actually something we're going to see a little bit more often with later opponents. Okay, he didn't get up. I'm surprised. KO! But this is what will start becoming a new standard with the later opponents. Some kind of weak point that they have that you're going to want to find and exploit that. This guy actually also has one, and this guy is always one that gives me trouble. The number one in the major circuit is Great Tiger from Bombay, India. Pretty good record, 24 wins, 5 losses only. And this might be the first time I lose, because I usually do. This guy actually has one of his super moves, also a staple thing that gets introduced in later opponents. They will also have a super move at some point. And this guy's super move is pretty dang annoying to avoid, so it usually gets me. Usually does not use it at the start of the game, but we'll see it come. This guy's tail is actually by his turban. You will see his turban flashing for a moment when he starts punching, so watch his turban, and whenever you see his emblem start flashing, then try to dodge. And the super punch is comparable to Van Keizer's. He will crouch down in front of you, and after a few moments he will start punching you. And if he misses you, then it's your chance to get him yourself. That is not something new, dang it. I don't know why I'm having so much trouble avoiding that move, because well, honestly it's not that hard to dodge. Ah, come on. Keep pressing too late. I'm already out of stamina. Okay, there we go. First time he goes down. Okay, this guy will get up. Okay, most of the explanation has been done, I think, so it's time to concentrate on this guy. Luckily, the first couple of opponents are pretty easy in this game. A pretty nice shot to end. Keep your guard up, Mac. So, a pussycat wants to fight a tiger. Yeah, I apologize. It's not in every opponent I am able to show off all of the dialogue, but the moment multiple rounds happen, I of course will. Most of them are pretty standard, though. Okay, here comes the super move. Oh, yeah, like I said, this is really annoying to dodge. He will actually start spinning around like a cyclone across the ring really fast. And you're going to want to try to avoid it by pressing left or right at the correct moment, or pressing down in order to block his moves. Only downside on pressing down is that it will cost you stamina. Because if he hits your block, it will actually drain your stamina. And it's really hard to avoid. But if you are able to do so, he will leave himself wide open for your attacks the moment that move ends. Okay, here it comes again. It does so much damage whenever it hits you. Even getting hit only twice will still knock you down. Okay, there I go. He beat me. Like I promised. Don't cry, Mac. You lost. Let's rematch. Are you ready for the next challenge? If you were afraid this game was easy, well, you see, I lost. The opponents can get pretty challenging. Like I said, this is a pretty hard game, especially in the later parts of this game. And yeah, we're 20 minutes, so the rematch is going to have to wait for tomorrow's episode. But this is the start for Mike Tyson's Punch-Out. Hope you enjoyed, and the real challenge will come up next time, as this match proved. This is where it starts becoming hard. See you folks next time. Treecks out.